The following program is not intended for children. It contains mild language, violence, sexual innuendo, wink, wink, brief nudity, and deals with mature themes that some viewers may find offensive. Parental discretion is strongly advised. Viewer discretion is advised.
In the criminal justice system, the people are represented by two separate yet equally important groups, the police who investigate crime and the district attorneys who prosecute the offenders. These are their stories.
Hi, my name is Jaleel Del Johnson. I am on a killing spree to rid this world of smokers. Some call me a serial killer, but I prefer to call myself vigilante, like Batman or the Green Arrow. I hope the government realizes what I am doing and bans tobacco products and thus causing tobacco companies to go out of business. So butt out, or you could be next.
I'm just walking home with my paycheck to support my wife and four kids. I'm the only one who works for my family, but they're so great that even without me talking to myself, they sure would be unfortunate if I were to get murdered right now.
But you don't know that smoke kills.
Yeah, but it's addictive.
Detective!
Morning, Agent.
Do we have an ID on our victim?
None.
Alright. You think it's the same guy?
Body shot, then burned. Up in the field. Pass me.
16 victims so far. The press has started calling him the fire killer.
We have to get him, but we're fine. No leads. We've got nothing.
Correction. Nothing.
What?
The killer dropped his wallet.
Are you kidding?
Jaleel Bell Johnson. 2249 Lock Street. This must be our guy. Detective, let's go put out the fire.
Welcome to my humble abode, officer. Police, drop the gun right now.
Or I could shoot you in the wiener.
Go ahead. Make my day. Lower it. Nice and slowly.
Chocolate.
Okay, now, on the ground.
It was dirty.
Get on the ground!
But I haven't cleaned in a while. I've been too busy killing people.
Get on the ground. Him down.
This is when you know life is just getting better.
Take my rifle.
At least you're not shooting me. I'm kind of happy.
Well, I've been waiting for this a long, long time.
Well, do you smoke?
Nope.
So why do we have a problem?
Because I'm a cop. I arrest people. That's what cops do.
Is that how that works? I dropped out of high school. I don't understand life.
Yeah, I kind of figured that.
I was abused as a child.
One of those antisocial types, you know what I'm saying?
I'm not antisocial.
You sure?
I had a party last night.
Alright.
You smoked
three. Shield off him.
Let me guess.
Other hand.
I saw that one come. I watch cops one. I got a watch on, so. You can take that off if you have to or whatever.
I can't really tell you where my watch is. You know, Dad, I appreciate how considerate you've been.
All rise from the Honorable Judge Joan Tran. May now be seated.
The sentencing of Jaleel Johnson on counts of multiple homicide is now in session.
Your Honor, the state recommends with proceeding on capital punishment.
On what grounds?
Well, Your Honor, we believe that sentencing the guilty party to death would provide an excellent deterrent to other criminals who are looking to commit the same offense.
Your Honor, there are no reliable statistics to prove that the death penalty deters crimes. In fact, most criminals act believing they won't be caught, and thus won't be deterred by the death penalty. Do you believe you would be caught, Mr. Bell Johnson?
No, sir, I did not.
Exactly!
What about the fact that our prisons are already overcrowded? Should we really be throwing in another prisoner who may never leave?
What difference does one more prisoner make?
Well, it's one more that the guards have to pay attention to in already cramped and crowded conditions. And they're having a hard enough time controlling that now. It's bad for security.
Would you please move on?
Yes, Your Honor. One of the most important facts is that an execution provides the victim's families with a sense of closure, a sense of retribution, feeling that he has finally paid for his crimes.
Your Honor, it is immoral to kill any human being, regardless of the circumstances.
Even Hitler?
Objection! That's irrelevant.
Sustained.
Withdrawn.
You may continue.
Thank you, Your Honor. Once again, the state should proceed with the execution of Mr. Bell Johnson, as it would help keep the public safe. If he is sentenced to prison, he could kill other inmates, prison guards, possibly escape and kill again, or be paroled and go right back to his killing ways. Therefore, the public would be best protected through the use of the death penalty.
Even at the cost of my client's life?
The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few. And finally, the state would save money by employing the death penalty, as we won't have to pay to feed and watch him for the rest of his life, not to mention the costs of degree programs and trades that are available to him while he's in prison.
Why does that matter now, as the trial involving the death penalty has already cost more than a regular trial due to the need for the extra witnesses, experts, and evaluations, all of which could have been avoided if the state did not pursue the death penalty in the first place?
Anything else?
No,
Your Honor. Anything to add, Counselor?
Yes. There is the possibility that we could convict an innocent person accidentally and sentence them to death.
With modern advancements in DNA and forensic technology, this scenario is highly unlikely.
Do you honestly believe that to be the truth?
You can't handle the truth!
Your Honor, the defense rests.
No, we don't. Keep on fighting, man.
Silence, or I will hold you in contempt.
Sorry, Your Honor.
I will now put the case to the jury to decide the man's fate.
When you were young, an open book. You used to say, live and let live.
You know you did.
But if this ever-changing world in which we live in makes you give in and cry, say, live and let die.
Tell them that I need more.